Ladies and gentlemen, what a fantastic night of boxing has been here tonight. Whether you're here live in our audience or you're watching somewhere on the World Wide Web, you may be watching from Byron Bay to Broome, from Cairns to Carnarvon, or if you are right here, it is time for our main event of the evening. Let's bring on the boom! Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. 10 rounds of boxing action for the WBO Global Super Lightweight title. Introducing first, our challenger, fighting out of the red corner, representing South Korea. Please welcome Hwang Kil Kim. Gentlemen, here we go. Introducing first, fighting out of our red corner. He weighed in at 63.2 kilos. His professional record, 12 fights, 11 victories, 5 by way of knockout. He trains under Hwang Sang Kim. He fights out of Seoul, South Korea. He is the WBA Asia champion. Please welcome Hwang Kil Kim. Fighting out of our blue corner, he weighed in at 63.3 kilos. His professional record, 17 fights, 17 victories, 11 by way of knockout. He trains under Alfie DiCarlo. He fights out of DC Boxing. He is the current WBO Global Super Lightweight Champion. He is Liam the Prodigy. Paro!
Hi guys, fellas, it's back to you back in the dressing room. So obey my commands at all times, protect yourselves at all times. I want a good clean fight. Touch gloves, good luck to both of you.
Final instructions from our referee, Paul Tapley. In charge of this bout, 10 three-minute rounds of boxing for the WBO Global Super Lightweight title. Let's make some noise, people! Let's do this!
Well, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. It's main event time for the WBO Global Super Lightweight title. Out of the blue corner, we've got Liam the Prodigy Paro. And in the red corner, Hwang Kil Kim from South Korea. James, interesting matchup.
Absolutely, it's an interesting matchup. So we see two different styles coming together here as well. We know the story of Liam Paro, we know the journey that he's on. We know what potentially awaits him at any opportunity. Every fight is a must-win fight for him on that journey. And he's got an opponent in front of him here who brings a an incredible record with him to this country, and he too knows he has a massive opportunity in front of him if he can come here tonight and he can defeat the prodigy, Liam Paro.
Yeah, well, Liam is now ranked, as we know, number 2 in the world with the WBO and number 3 in the world with the IBF, so a world title shot could be imminent for him. We saw him last time in June this year where he was able to secure a gritty win over Turkish Olympian Fateh Kellis, but this potentially is another step up again, so we'll see what pans out here tonight.
Right, step back, step back.
As we know, James, these South Koreans, they're always very gritty and well prepared, and they usually, most times are not, when they come over to Australia, they rock the boats and of our Australian fighters, and they always put up a big test for our Aussie boys. So we'll see if this is any different here tonight.
No doubt about it, and it started this way, the same fashion. So as we see our visitor here, as he does wear a few on the wane now against Liam Paro, but he did charge out to centre ring. He's keen to move forward, but at the moment, he just can't break that rhythm of Liam Paro. We know very, very sharp, extremely sharp southpaw. And again, you talk about ring craft. He's certainly able to control distance and with his speed and with his precision punching. And that's what he's doing right now, as you can see him digging down to the body.
Well, this will be Liam's fifth straight international opponent in a row. So he's been at that high level for a little while now. So he's gradually stepping up every fight as he tries to press towards that world title, that coveted world title. But Hwang himself, he's the WBA Asian champion and is the number one ranked super lightweight in his country. So this is no easy night out for Liam Paro.
And reading comments in the media, Liam Paro's trainer, Alfie DiCarlo, said that he does expect the South Korean to come out hard. And he's spot on, because that's exactly what he has done here in this opening round.
And James, we know he can go the distance because his last two fights have been wins over 12 rounds. So there's no disputing that he's got plenty of juice in his tank.
That's round number one, main event here, with thanks to Ace Boxing Promotions.
The more he warms to this fight, I think the better Liam will get.
We're counting down around the number 2. The corner works away there on Liam Paro. And also we see the other corner here, very, very active. Encouraging his fight along here, Hwang Kil Kim. So this is round number 2. With you tonight from the Eaton's Hill Hotel. Beautiful complex here. This is round 2. One thing's for sure, they both bound out of the corner. There's no... There's no dramas finding each other when they both hit centre ring at speed, straight out of those corners. So a lot of intent shown from both fighters.
Yeah, like bull out of a gate they are. There's a good left-hand lead there from Liam Paro just before, hitting the mark as he puts a combination there together. Hwang Kil Kim leading to the body. Right. Another good tactic there from the South Korean. Box. Trying to whip over that left hand is Liam Paro. What a good shot there from Hwang Kil Kim as well.
It was a great shot over the top.
A good evasion there from Liam Paro as he skips to the center of the ring. That's where he's safest. Good jab.
Is it very obvious that the visitor here, he doesn't want to allow Paro to set. He doesn't want to allow him to get into any sort of rhythm whatsoever.
100%. Well, when you've got a power puncher in front of you, you don't give him time to set. When they've got time to set, that's when they're the most dangerous. Good body shot there from Liam Paro, digging into the body, then finishing up to the head. Clubbing right hand, Liam Paro, and then he follows up with a right rip as well. Oh, and a good left hand there from Liam Paro as well, knocking back the head of Hwang Kil Kim. These are good shots from both boys here. This is a good exchange here.
This is a great fight.
Right, step back, step back.
These South Koreans, they are always up for the test.
This is a terrific fight. Only 2 rounds in. I hope you're enjoying it wherever you're watching it.
Yeah, plenty of punches being thrown and plenty connecting from both boys, but Liam Paro obviously getting the better of the exchanges. Oh, two and three punches there from Liam Paro, and then there's the receipt from Hwang Kil Kim.
Watch your heads in there, guys.
Both boys, you can see this is the top level, leading to the body, finishing to the head, like we've seen in many of our supporting bouts tonight.
Right! Right. Tighten it up, guys. Oh.
Good high guard there from Hwang Kil Kim coming in. That was a good body assault there from Liam Paro.
Beautiful work to the body.
Paul Tapley doing a good job there. Refereeing just letting them fight out. Another good round, round two.
Both boys are going to need to be fit here, Nathan, because they're fighting at a pretty frenetic pace.
Yeah, and they are. There's no doubt about that, as we can see some of the highlights of the previous round. It was a good right hook there from Liam Paro, opening up his opponent, who was also equal to the task with his own flurry of punches there. But there's the power shots are coming from Paro, but the culmination of punches are coming from Kil Kim. But how are you scoring it? I mean, it's I give it to Paro, just from power punching and a little bit more precision.
We'll see how the judges are scoring it if we go to the scorecards once we get through 10, if we get to that stage. But as I said, it's a frenetic pace, no doubt about that, between our two main event fighters here.
And the South Korean opponent here tonight, I think we know he's going to be there the distance. Like I said, his last two previous fights have gone the full 12 rounds, and he was throwing the whole way through the fight.
Right! Step back, let him up, let him up. Box.
See Liam Paro trying to put out his range finder. There's a clubbing right hand there, hitting the mark there from Paro. That's another good left hand there from Paro.
Beautiful.
As he hits him with two good shots there once again.
Right.
And it's shots like that, combination like that, that if you're going to slow a man down, that's probably the way that it's going to happen. But it hasn't happened yet.
No. He's equal to the task, this Hwang Kil Kim. He's a man possessed. He's marching forward. His eyes are very focused. You don't become the WBA Asian champion by chance, I'll tell you that much. You have to earn that title, and this man is the champion of that title. So that's a testament to the type of fighter he is and the challenge that Liam's taken on here tonight.
This is a great fight.
Oh, big clubbing left hand hitting the mark there from Liam Paro.
Watch your heads in there, guys. Watch your head. Work out of it. Work out of it, both of you.
Plenty of punches being thrown in these opening three rounds. A lot more than we're used to for this caliber of fighter anyway. They usually ease their way into a fight, especially in these long distance rounds. Wow, we a couple of good shots there from Paro, but here comes Hwang Kil Kim back. That's a good shot there from Paro, the left hand hitting the mark.
Right! Step back,
step back. As the crowd gets behind Liam Paro. As he chops downstairs and back up the top.
We need to draw on their energy here tonight, because I think this guy is going to be there for a long time.
Incredible.
Hwang Kil Kim. He's got every punch in the book.
Work out of it, work out of it. Right.
He's hitting him at varying paces as well. He's not loading up every punch. He's whipping one in every now and again, but he's tap, 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 and then he's sinking in one. Very experienced fighter. There's a left hook there from Hwang Kil Kim. And there's a big left hand from Liam the Prodigy Paro that ends the round.
And Nathan, for everything that this South Korean has worn, he has not taken half a step back. He has not taken an inch of a step back.
Well, I was watching some videos, obviously, in preparation here for tonight of him, and he doesn't have a reverse gear, this Hwang Kil Kim. He is all action, always on the front foot, never takes a backward step. And look, true to that form, he's doing it here tonight again.
Absolutely, he is. Look at this. So here again, he's marching forward. Throwing. Where's one? Comes straight back. He's a very dangerous fighter, and you can see why he's amassed the record he has and earned the titles that he has.
He's had the 12 fights, 11 wins, only the one loss. But like I said, that loss came early in his career. I think it was his second fight. So he's had obviously 10 straight wins now, and he's had a couple of big wins of late over those 12 round distance.
And that's an important stat. He's been the journey before. He's been beyond the 10, as you pointed out there. There's a couple of 12 rounders. He's won decisions over 12, so he's quite durable.
As we see, another good shot there from Liam Paro. All the water spraying off the top of their head. You can really emphasize the point now every time they get hit. This South Korean hasn't come here for a walk around the park or a vacation. He's come here to win this title. There's no doubt about it. WBO Global Super Lightweight title on the line. Obviously, Liam is defending that because he won in his last bout, which was over Fateh Kalis, a Turkish Olympian.
Right. Step back. Get your head out of it. Wait, keep your head out of it. Box.
Two and three good shots there from Liam Paro, trying to keep his opponent at bay as he tries to step back and step to the side and create a different angle to come in on. Hwang Kil Kim coming in with right hand leads, left hands, another right hand there, hitting the mark. Wowee, there's some punches thrown
this is
in
a fight.
Fight. James.
This is a fantastic fight. This is a great contest between two young champion fighters. I hope you're enjoying it wherever you're watching it. The crowd's loving it here.
Don't hold his head down.
Frenetic pace with, well, this is into the fourth round. Liam Paro starting to land some beautiful crisp shots. Normally, I would think that would be enough to slow down the opponent, but you've mentioned the pedigree of this young man that's in the ring with him, and you've mentioned you've watched him fight, and you've seen what he's done for 12 rounds.
Yep.
Let's see.
And these South Koreans are some kind of tough, as we saw in previous fight nights. The South Korean was the one that put down Tyson Best, and that was that brutal KO that we spoke about early on in the coverage. That was a South Korean that night, and here's a South Korean tonight. They come prepared every single time. That was a good left hand there from Liam Paro hitting the mark. As Hwang Kil Kim comes back himself. This is a competitive fight, but a very good one for Liam Paro in the stage of his career right now.
That's the end of the round, Nathan. I think that was Liam Paro's best round so far in terms of, I think he's finding his distance a little bit more now, and he's able to pick off the South Korean, who's coming forward and, as we said, just coming straight forward at him and not wanting to give him a chance to breathe. And he's been able to use those silky skills that we know that he's got to pick off his opponent here. You see some of the highlights of this round.
The more punches are coming from the South Korean, but the better shots are coming from Liam Paro. The more crisp, the more effective shots. So, I mean, usually in a professional boxing fight, that's the ones that count. So you would think the judges see it that way, but you never know. They mean business, don't they, James?
Can you interpret that for me?
I think he's saying kill, kill, kill.
He's very animated in the corner.
His name is Hwang Kil Kim, so it makes sense. The opening part of this round is fast once again. Hwang Kil Kim coming in like a raging bull, coming in with tens and twenties shots at a torrent. He's relentless from the South Korean. Liam Paro trying to once again come off at a different angle, trying to pop the head back of the South Korean. And that was a good shot there. He was effective there.
And here's Kil Kim coming back with 1,000 punches of his own.
Well, they're going to have to be fit to go 10 rounds at this pace, I tell you that much. Look at these punches. This is a crazy fanatical speed.
Step back. Box.
18th pro fight for Liam tonight. This is no doubt probably going to be his hardest as he gradually steps up every fight.
Tight it up, both ears. Box.
Leading to the body, Hwang Kil Kim. He tries to drop the guard of Liam Paro. Boy, he's got his back to the ropes. He almost fights like a Jeff Fennec, this South Korean. He just relentless punches, throws punches and bunches, throws his punches from anywhere. He's just an all-out attack fighter.
Incredible fight this has been.
This is carnage, James O'Shea. I can't believe this. This can't go for 10 rounds. This is
surely not.
Too many punches.
Again, we've said it before, but credit to the camps of both of these boys. They deserve credit there. The camps here that you can tell they've done the work.
Yeah.
Because they fought at the speed probably of many 10-round, 12-round fights in the space of five.
Let me tell you, if you haven't done the work, you'll get found out in this fight. This is at a fanatical speed. Like I said, it's just crazy the amount of punches they've thrown. They've thrown more punches in these first opening rounds than somebody would throw in a whole world title fight over 12 rounds.
Not only punches thrown, punches connected.
Yeah, correct. And another brutal. Here tonight. Look at the uppercut right hand. He's a crazy man, this South Korean, Hwang Kil Kim.
This is round six.
Good shot there from Liam Paro, catching his opponent on the way in, but Hwang Kil Kim trying to bully Paro back to the ropes. He's got to keep that rangefinder out. That's good there from Liam. He's got to keep something in his face to keep him at bay. And then walk him onto that big left hand. But always something has to be out there.
Right, step back, guys.
As the crowd starts to get behind Liam Paro again.
Good combination of punches there from Paro, but good defense from Hwang Kil Kim as well as he turns and pours the pressure back on Liam.
Right, step back, step back. Tidy it up. Box.
That was a good shot there from Liam, knocking the head back of Juan.
Work out of it. Right. Step back. Before
I'm referee Paul Taplich was to separate them.
That was a good left-hand lead there from Paro. Oh, and another good shot there from Paro. He's hit him with a couple of good shots in the space of 10 seconds here.
I think Paro senses an opportunity here.
Right. Kick it. Liam, get your forearm out of it.
A couple of warnings on the fly there from referee Paul Tapley.
Right, step back.
Good body work from both boys. And a good left hand over the top once again from Paro. Sorry, right hand over the top rather.
Step back.
As the seconds tick away on another frenetic round, we've got over 30 seconds to go in the round.
Watch your heads in there. Right, step back.
Tell you one thing, Nate, this is a fight where you learn how much do they want it. This takes a lot of desire.
Yeah, it's no game in there, obviously. It's a full contact sport, and there's plenty of contact here tonight.
Right.
10 seconds to go in this round. We'll see how it closes out here as the South Korean marches forward, but Liam Paro catches him with two good shots on the way in. But the Korean comes back and bullies him into the corner. What a round again.
Tough job for our judges as well, who have to officiate this one and sort out the rounds. Here we go. So here he is at the start of the round.
Dancing at the start of the round.
Sort of a half Gangnam style, isn't it?
That's a show of confidence right there. But
yes.
I tell you what, I think he should stick to boxing because he's not a good dancer. But he's definitely a good boxer, I'll tell you that much. Because you can see here, there was a good shot there from Liam Paro. He doesn't give you much. Hwang Kil Kim.
The corners too here, working overtime with their fighters just because it's at such a fast pace. And I suppose they're just giving them simple instructions each time in the corner because of the speed at which this fighter's been fought. As we start again at the same speed, they meet center ring.
He does not have an off button, this right. Hwang Kil Kim. It's 100% all the time. It's just crazy.
10%.
150%.
Right. Step back.
So many punches in one fight. And you can see Hwang coming, leading with the right hand, trying to load up. He's got every punch in the book as well. He comes up under to the body, to the head, and gets his head to the side very effectively, so he gets his own head out of harm's way as well. Two and three good shots there from Liam Paro as he comes forward, but this South Korean is relentless. Good shot there from Liam Paro once again, popping the head back of Hwang Kil Kim.
Minute down in our seventh round, scheduled for 10.
No knockdown there, you know, it's just a slip the canvas from Liam Paro. He does not want to stop working, the South Korean. But there goes Liam Paro with his own burst of energy.
Right, step back.
What a contest.
Right.
Brutal contest.
They'll both know they're in a fight tomorrow morning, I tell you that much.
These two boys will be sore for a month.
That was two and three good shots there from Liam Paro. Really knocking the head back of Hwang Kil Kim. They were probably the most effective of the whole fight so far.
And what's Kim do? Come back.
Right, step back.
As you said, he does not have a reverse button of any nature.
He's, oh, they're just non-stop, are they, James? Oh. And that was a good left hand from Liam Paro there as he gets on his bike and takes a couple of steps back, but Hwang Kil Kim throws another four and five punches. Well, you can really see this the world level, but can't you, James? I mean, there's a step up, obviously, from our undercard fights. It's just a different level again, isn't it?
The speed that they're fighting at, the tenacity that's there, the will.
The precision in every punch.
Crowd walk away disappointed. I don't know what they need from a fight like this, and this has got them on the edge of their seat.
Well, they don't like boxing if they go away disappointed, I'll tell you that much. And that's the end of the seventh round. There's still three rounds to go. Can you believe it in this contest?
We're seven rounds down, 8, 9, 10. That's what's left.
As we see some of the replays from the previous round, it was a good clubbing right hand. Of 10. Here we go, and it starts with the South Korean right. Running
step back.
Forward.
Step back.
Look at this pressure. It's a testament to the fitness of Paro, because I tell you what, if he wasn't right. Fit, he would have been gone a long time ago.
Tidy same up the boat here. Him, I can't believe the fitness level of him. He physically looks strong and fit. Like, there's not an ounce, both of them, is it? There's not an ounce on either of them, but the right. Work that they're putting right. Into this fight.
It's just crazy. Crazy speed. Starting right. To get a little bit messy here. Both boys tangling up, trying to wrestle their way through this fight. As Kim works to the body, works to the head. Paro comes back with the receipt, popping his head. Half a step back, back on. It does not stop. Good shots there from Paro, leading to the body. But look at Kim. Oh, there's a right hand over the top. Caught the attention of Paro. Look at this relentless pressure.
Right! Step back!
Incredible. Incredible the pressure that's before this. This is, what was that, round number eight?
Eight. Tell you what, both boys will sleep well tonight.
And it hasn't stopped. It has not stopped from the opening bell.
Look at this pressure. Right hand, left hand. Here's Paro come back. He needs to dig deep in this fight, and he's starting to do that now. But here comes Kil
right.
Kim.
Step back. Step back. Keep it tidy, boys. Come on. Box.
That's a good body shot there to lead from Liam Paro as he comes back to the head. Works to the head. Back to the body.
Right.
Both step boys back. Are starting step to back. Get fatigued. You can see the perspiration coming from their head.
Right, step back.
And
step
this back. Is where their head, concentration man. Has to come into it. They're fatiguing, or they had to at some stage. It's the speed that this fight's before. They haven't fatigued yet, but
guys.
This is where I'm sure with their corners they really want them to concentrate on the game plan and to really tighten things up. Because this is
right.
A crucial,
step
crucial
step
stage
back.
Of the fight.
Let him up. Step back.
Wowee. 19 seconds to go in this eighth round. We've still
keep
got two
up,
more
keep
rounds
up.
Of this.
Keep him up. Just so. Slow. Keep him up.
a warning there from Paul Tapley. It's a little bit below the belt from Liam Paro. He's right to go though. He's saying, I'm ready to fight on. Now, a big left hand there to finish out round eight for Liam Paro.
Those are tough, tough rounds.
Hard to score because there's so many punches and so many, I guess, they're coming in so many times and grappling and obviously whatever you do, I do better sort of thing. So it's very hard to score this fight. But, I mean, the more decisive shots have definitely come from Paro. So you've got to give him credit for that.
That was we're looking at the highlights this year. This was a very good round for South Korean. He had a very, very strong round, in particular here in the eighth. So again, both were showing no signs of slowing down. We've got two rounds to come.
The Korean wouldn't blow out a candle. Look at the fitness on this kid. It's also a testament to Liam's fitness as well. He looks...
Both of these boys, they deserve a round of applause whenever we get to the finish of this. They deserve a round of applause. It's been an amazing performance. Amazing performance for both fighters.
Tied it up.
We've still got 6 minutes to go.
Yeah, we still do. Both boys trying to wrestle in close as Liam hits him with a couple of shots, ducks his head and creams the style once again of Hwang Kil Kim, the WBA Asian champion. Up and under there from Hwang Kil Kim, trying to knock back the head of Liam Paro, but here comes the receipt from Paro. He has to be on the balls of his toes now. He's just got to start bouncing on his feet, moving in and out, keeping his distance. Oh, and a big right hand there from Hwang Kil Kim. Oh, there's two and three punches here from Kim. He's got to really hold on here, does Paro. He's doing a good job, very smart what he did. Tied him up, gets him back to center ring and back on the jab. Very good there from Liam.
Had some huge moments this round has Hwang Kil Kim.
Oh, and a good body shot there from Kil Kim. This is a tough fight. This is the international level. This is a world-rated fight anywhere in the world.
That's the whiskers on both boys.
This kid does not have an off button. I've said it before, but I've never seen the amount of punches thrown around than this kid has thrown. You have to take it back to the Jeff Fennec days to get the same amount of punches.
Love to see the stats on the amount of punches thrown.
Oh, look at this. This is crazy speed. And there's still 4 minutes to go.
The crowd trying to will Liam Paro on here. And he needs a little bit of help from the crowd. And that's one of the things you get from fighting at home.
Yes, he does. There's a good right hand, but there's a receipt from Liam, the prodigy Paro. He needs every bit of his endurance here to get through this contest. Good left hand there from Paro. Good scoring shot.
Round nine. Looking to steal the round.
Oh, and he might have just done that right there with a couple of good clean shots. Kill Kim. And there's a couple of good shots there from Paro.
Yeah. Please tell me that I can't, that I won't, that I fail, that I'll never make it out, yeah. Please tell me all the bad, never good, fill my head full of every single doubt, yeah. Please say any negative thoughts, I pop off when I hear people say I cannot. I get off to the thought of proving everyone wrong, I won't stop to the top, so you better back off or get lost. I'ma stay loud, stay proud, never running out, never heading south. I'll be spreading out, call it word of mouth, can't put me down, I'll be getting loud. You can have your doubts, not what I'm about, have your fucking clout. It be raining now, I keep making sound, go another round, bitch I'm legend bound, can't stop me now.
You don't wanna fuck with me. slow burn like a disease. Just tell me that I can and I'll show you things that you couldn't believe. Just tell me that I can. Just tell me that I can. Just tell me that I can. Just tell me that I can.
Ready to go. As they embrace for the 10th and final round.
Unbelievable nine rounds so far. We have one round left to go.
For the WBO global title, will Liam defend it here?
This is probably the slowest start for Kim, and that's purely because he had to touch gloves in the middle.
How dare he? There's a good left hook there from, or right hook there from Liam Paro. He's just got to stay on his toes here, Liam Paro. He's got to be right in and out. He's got to be darting on his feet. Can't be stuck in the mud here. If he's got flat feet, that's when he's in big danger against this kind of opponent.
Right. Step back.
Good turn there from Paro. That's it. He's going to get on the balls of his toes here. That's it. Do what you have to. Wrap him up. Get through the round.
Just maul and hold.
Step back.
And back on his toes. That's it. Good right hand there from Paro. Kill Kim. Look at him. He's a man possessed, marching forward.
Digs to the body. That's Kim as he comes forward. He's looking to throw those trademark million punches. Paro right. Holds on.
Step back. Tied it up, fellas.
Oh, and a good left hand there from Kill Kim as he tries to finish this round with a big bang, but Paro equal to the task. Good shots there from Paro. Three-shot combination there. As Kim tries to dig to the body in the breaks.
Minute 24 to go.
A good shot there from Paro. Oh, and a good left hand there from Paro. Will that be enough to steal this round as well? As Kill Kim, look at this, the onslaught.
We're into the final 60 seconds, let's make some noise!
Final minute of this grueling contest. Who will be crowned WBO Global Champion as Hwang Kil Kim comes marching forward?
Incredible fight. We're under a minute on at the clock. Two boys in the ring here who believe they can win this fight. 30 seconds left.
Good jab to the body there from Paro as Kill Kim comes back on. That's it, good varying shots there. Varying his levels, Paro, as he comes up with his punches. And Kill Kim straight to the body, straight to the head.
Work out of it.
And they're going to finish the way they started.
Step back.
And here's the last little snippet of the round, and that's the end. Stand and applaud, because there's been a million punches thrown in that contest.
Unbelievable fight, Nathan DiCapello. I cannot believe what we just witnessed. I cannot believe the relentless pressure for 10 rounds.
I'm exhausted watching it. Honestly, that is crazy.
Here's a couple of highlights here of the last round.
What do you know, Hwang Kil Kim on the front foot, throwing plenty of punches. But the pot shots come from Liam, the prodigy Paro.
Like that one there's
the ones
saw.
That rock the head back come from Paro. So I think that's the decisive shots.
How will the judges see it? We're going to find out shortly. We'll head up the center ring shortly to get the decision.
They've earned their paycheck, both boys, here tonight.
Again, as we said a few times, have a look at him. Look at Kil Kim, he's fresh.
Wouldn't blow out a candle.
After 10 rounds of boxing action, we go to the judges' scorecards. Our judges score this fight: 98-92, 98-93, 98-92, all for the winner, by unanimous decision, and still the WBO Global Super Lightweight Champion, Liam the Prodigy, Paro.
And there it is, a unanimous points victory to Liam Paro.
And ladies and gentlemen, Liam Paro retains his WBO Global title. It was a tough fight, probably the toughest of his career, but he's still there, undefeated. Thanks for joining us tonight at this beautiful venue, the Eaton's Hill Hotel. I'm Dave Allen, the Fight MC, and until we see you next time, keep your hands up. Good night.